The second reading for today describes the Word of God as living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joint and marrow. Everything is naked and exposed to the eyes of Him to whom we must render an account. As explained by Brant Petrie, the two-edged sword in this verse from Hebrews is a reference to a double-bladed sword that Roman soldiers used in warfare. It was known, this double-edged sword, for quickly and effectively cutting into opponents, which is why it is used. For this two-edged sword was sharp and effective in cutting through even bones and exposing what's in the cavity of the bones, which is the marrow. Similarly, when we meditate on the Word of God and expose ourselves to the Word of God, we allow the Word of God to cut through us spiritually, penetrating and revealing the marrow of our beings, the hidden and concealed aspects of our lives that we carefully hide away, even from ourselves, as marrow is hidden and concealed, sheathed by bone. A possible reason that Petrie proposes for many of us for not reading sacred scripture in a prayerful, meditative way is because we don't want to be spiritually cut open by the Word of God, which is sharper than any two-edged sword. We prefer remaining in ignorance. And why? Since the Word of God can cut through our not physical bones, but spiritual bones, the hidden structures of our interior life, and exposing them, bringing them to light, revealing to us our hidden motives and hidden aspects of our lives that God wants us to repent from by turning away from sin and believing in the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, who rescues us from our addictive patterns that only lead us to misery, although they promise exactly the opposite. They promise us happiness. But it's like hitting our head against the wall, expecting the wall to give us happiness, and it doesn't. It just gives us more and more of a headache. Not the genuine happiness and peace of soul that Jesus Christ, His good news, and cooperating with His grace, gradually growing and reordering ourselves in accordance with the truth of God. The gospel passage today contains words of Jesus that, when reflected upon, can easily cut through my spiritual bones, your spiritual bones, exposing our full identity. In the gospel passage, Jesus tells us that it is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than it is for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. Since ancient times, this image of a camel passing through the eye of a needle has been debated. Is it a reference to a camel passing through a small little needle, or is it reference to a camel who tries to get through a very low gate called the needle, and he can't get through the gate because of his hump prevents him from entering into the gates into Jerusalem, representing, of course, the heavenly city of Jerusalem. I like both explanations, and perhaps God has providentially allowed this debate to take place, since both interpretations shed different light on the dangers of riches. Focusing on the second image of a camel coming to a low gate and not being able to pass through because of its tall hump that prevents the camel from passing through, a pope has described the camel's hump, his tall hump, as representing pride that prevents us from entering into the kingdom of God. And the only way to enter the heavenly city of Jerusalem is by going down on our knees and crawling through in humility. And that would be the only way for a camel to get through that gate, is to go down on its knees and crawl through in an act of humility to get into the city of Jerusalem. May the Word of God cut through our souls and spirits, joints and marrows. In so doing, may the Word of God lay bare to our eyes, to my eyes, my interior life, your interior life, and lay it naked and exposed so that, glancing on our hidden motives in the light of God's love and mercy, we may let go of our proud humps that stick up in the air, preventing us from kneeling down and preventing us from passing into the heavenly city of God. And we can only do so by kneeling down, asking for God's mercy, and then because of that humility, passing through the gate of humility into the kingdom of God. God bless you.